वेलकम एवरीवन. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लीन गंगा मिशन एंड आल्सो द नमामि गंगे प्रोग्राम. सो द नमामि गंगे प्रोग्राम एज वेल एज क्लीन गंगा मिशन, ऑल दिस हैज़ बीन अ फ्लैगशिप प्रोग्राम ऑफ द प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट. एंड इनफैक्ट नॉट जस्ट द प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट, दिस हैज़ बीन गोइंग ऑन फॉर डिकेड. बट इफ यू गो बाय द जजमेंट्स प्रेजेंटेड बाय द सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड इवन द एक्सपर्ट, इट सेज दैट क्लीनिंग ऑफ गंगा इज गोइंग टू टेक डेकेड्स बिफोर इट कम्स टू अ pristine state. So this is the few of the topics that we will discuss in our video today. So let's move forward. So Namami Gange, the central government ambitious project to clean Ganga, seem to have delivered modest result, with the quality of river water from Rudraprayag in Uttarakhand to Ulubai in West Bengal having improved between 2014 and 19 according to Jal Shakti Ministry data. But experts says that it will take decades before the water becomes fit for human consumption. So the things for you to notice over here is that there is an improvement. So since 2014 we can see there has been improvement in the quality of water. But what could be concluded from here is that even if there is an improvement, the improvement is at snail pace and the water has not become fit for human consumption. So the water of Ganga is still not fit for human consumption, and even though there is an improvement in the overall pollution level in Ganga, it is still way behind what it should be. This dissolved oxygen level or the amount of oxygen available to living aquatic organism has improved at 27 locations. So basically the dissolved oxygen level has also improved. The biochemical oxygen demand, or what we call as BOD, the amount of oxygen consumed by bacteria while they decompose organic matter and fecal coliform, measure of the suitability of water for consumption has also improved in various locations. So again, even though it has not become fit for human consumption, there is an improvement on account of BOD. Biological oxygen demand content has also improved. So this is few of the good news which you could consider, but we still have a long way ahead. Now let's move forward and try to understand what are these indicators. So basically, higher dissolved oxygen shows whether water can sustain aquatic life or not. So just remember, if the oxygen level in any aquatic water body is low, it basically means that the aquatic life cannot survive over there, because aquatic life need oxygen to survive. A lower BOD shows there is a less bacteria and other microorganism in the water. Now biochemical oxygen demand drops, it means that the organic matter or the microorganism is less, because this is the particular oxygen which is required to break down organic matter and microorganism. So if there is less BOD number, it means that there is less organic matter or microorganism to be break down by the microorganism in the water. The fecal coliform indicates the amount of sewage in the water. So as mentioned earlier, not only organic matter, there is also FC, which is called as fecal coliform. It also indicates what is the amount of sewage present in the water. So Jal Shakti Minister data shows that in past 6 years, the water quality of the river on these three parameters has improved marginally at most location. And at this pace, the authorities would take decades to river water fit for human consumption. Central government has initially fixed 2019 as the deadline to clean the river, but extended it to 2022 as Namami Ganga project took off slowly. So just remember over here, the earlier deadline was 2019. Now it is already extended to 2022. But what the experts are actually highlighting is that even by 2022, it will be a very uphill task to be able to clean the Ganga to an extent where its water become fit for human consumption. So the thing that you have to remember from here is, what is BOD? And when we are talking about, just also go through what is COD. How these two factors help us to determine the pollution in water body. So just remember, if BOD is low, what happens? If BOD is high, what happens? And also we are talking about the FC content. So FC, the fecal coliform content, this also indicate the sewage. what is the amount of sewage like present in the water body and how much pollution it has caused. So these three factors are the one which you need to remember from this particular slide. Next, let's go forward and see what is the Namami Gange project is all about. So under the Namami Gange project, there has been around 231 project which has been sanctioned. And just look at the number. The maximum are there in Uttar Pradesh, which is 112. Then in Uttarakhand, there are 47, 20 in West Bengal, 26 in Bihar, and 26 in Jharkhand, Haryana, and Delhi. These are the riparian estates of Ganga. What is the cost which has been allocated? It is rupees 2000 crore. So rupees 2000 crore has been allocated for the Namami Gange project. And what is the basic features which has been improved upon this project? These are, it is going for the modernization of ghats and cremation. So if you remember, if you have seen any movies or if you have been around Banaras, Haridwar, these are all the ghats of Ganga where the cremation happens, and it could also be one of the region of pollution, and hence modernization of ghats is one of the requirement. Then development of sewage infrastructure and treatment. So if we are able to develop infrastructure where the sewage could be treated beforehand, before it entered the river, we will be able to bring down the pollution level to a minimum level. Then afforestation. So basically, forestation is one of the things which could help the river to avoid these problems of siltation. Then it could also help to avoid the erosion caused by the river banks. Then the pilot drain project, so that the siltation could take place. So what happened when there is a lot of deposition, river water, these deposition get accumulated at the bottom or the river bed. So when this river bed is getting accumulated with the deposition, it reduces the carrying capacity of river, hence causing problem for it to carry water. So desiltation process is one of the way by which we remove this deposition from the river bend and hence increase the carrying capacity of the river. Then interceptor of drain project, trash management, as well as preserving biodiversity. So these are all the features that you need to remember what has been introduced under the Namami Gange project. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to comment on this video. Thank you.